Hi and welcome back to my little corner of the internet. Today we're going to make gaiters of shoe leg covers. And the way I'm going to do that is by using plastic wrap, some tape, and a marker. But first I'm going to put the plastic wrap around my legs so I have the right size. Then we're going to put some tape on the top and on the bottom to keep that in place. And then I'm going to trace how I want the design to be of these gaiters. On the bottom and then center front and center back. And where I want the buttons to go on the side. I'm going to do this on both legs. Then we're gonna cut them off at center front. And then I'm going to cut that apart and then trace on some paper. And the reason why I did both legs is so I could see if there was any big difference, if I needed to make one for each leg, but the difference wasn't too big. So I ended up just using the right leg as a template for my pattern. So I'm just gonna trace that onto some paper and make my pattern pieces. Marking off where I'm going to have the side seam, where the opening is going to be, where the buttons closure is going to be as well. Remembering to mark off what's center back, what's center front. Making assembly marks is always a good thing. Just cleaning up the lines. Here are the pattern pieces. This is going to be the side where I put on the buttons, and the other one is the inner. So I'm gonna cut that out. The inner part is just going to be as is, but the side part I'm going to make into two pieces where I put on some extra that's going to be folded over. So you have, you know, like a button placket. These are the buttons. Just taking how big they are to see, or to like make an estimate of how wide that the button placket is going to be. This is just a guess because I don't really know. And I'm just seeing how many buttons I want there to be. I think I ended up putting on 10. Again, just to check the design of it. And you can see I made the pattern into two pieces now. So I have three. Two for the outside, one for the inner. And before I'm going to cut this out in the fabric, I'm going to tape them together and then try them on to see if the fit is right, because moving something from plastic wrap to paper can be a bit tricky because the plastic wrap is elastic and the paper isn't. So I'm just gonna try that on, and it ended up not being big enough at the side. So I'm adding about 4 centimeters to the side, taping that in, tracing that out, Then I'm gonna tape it back together and then try it again. There's a lot of try-ons with making these gaiters, but this time it fits. As you can see. And I'm just gonna try it on the other leg as well to see if it still fits. And it does. So that's awesome. Always a good thing to double check. Now I'm going to put that pattern on some fabric. This is regular canvas cotton, or cotton canvas in black, as you can see. And I'm going to make this in a one layer. So there are only going to be seam allowance on the sides, because that's where I'm going to sew that together. Then I'm going to put binding on the top and on the fronts and on the sides. And after sewing the parts together, I steamed or ironed the seam allowance to each side. Then I'm going to cut one side and then fold the other side over to make the seam a bit stronger and to make it a bit prettier, because it's only going to be one layer. And I'm of course doing this to the both gaiters for each leg, one for the left side, one for the right side. Now I'm going to put on some binding. And my sewing machine is still having a bit of a hissy fit, so this was a bit tricky because the thread and the under thread, and yeah, it wasn't pretty. But I ended up making it work at the end. Finishing off the binding. Folding that under and just giving a little seam as close to the binding as I can. And let's put in some buttons. I'm going to measure out where I want them to be. I think it's 4 centimeters apart. Just marking that off. And checking how big I want buttonhole to be. And after making the buttonholes, I tried it on again. And then pinned it together. And then marked off where I want the buttons to be. Again, doing this because fitting is pretty important with a pair of gaiters. So instead of me thinking where I thought the buttons would be, then I just thought, well, let's let my leg and the gaiters decide where the buttons is going to be. So that's what I did. Pinning them together. Marking off where the button is going to be. And as you can see, it wasn't a straight line, so it was good that I did it this way. Let's put in some buttons. Just trying to see if all the buttonholes fit. And when I did this, it worked on one side, all the buttons, and on the other side, the front bit of the button popped off. So I have to buy some super glue to glue them on, because I'm not buying new buttons, but that's a bit annoying. Just trying them on. And of course, we cannot end the project without snacks. So enjoy some bunny spam. This is my lion head, Quentin Bear. She's just so adorable. But here they are, done, on, and awesome. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!